Good morning, good brothers and good sisters, and praise the Lord.
Good sisters, good brothers. Yes. Very nice. That's the best way to begin a day.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
So even if you're not good, you feel good.
Yes. Yeah.
Father, let's have the first joke in the morning.
Yes. A teacher in the class asked the students, "Now I'm going to ask you a question, and one who gives the right answer, you will have the cell phone the teacher had,
yeah.
The Android phone. He said, this phone is going to be yours."
Wow.
Yeah. And the teacher asked one boy, mm-hmm. "How many men, the number of men, did Jesus feed?"
Mm-hmm.
The boy got up immediately and said, "There were 500 men.
Oh.
And sorry, 5,000 men. 5,000 men.
That's
the teacher
I
said, "Very good. And this mobile is yours. But before I give the mobile to you, I want to tell you something. Now you have to ask a question back to me,
yeah.
And if I answer it rightly, then you should return the mobile back to me."
Oh.
Okay, the boy was very clever. He received the mobile and asked the question back to the teacher. "Now teacher, you tell me the names of all those 5,000 men."
Wow, wait, you're being bold over, huh?
Yeah.
Oh my God, beautiful, beautiful, yeah. Beautiful, very nice. My dear brothers and sisters, today we are coming to a very important question. One is, everyone who walks into the church feels it is their church, which is very good. But people abuse the church. Father,
yeah.
This is what I don't like. People are using the church for a lot of unwanted things.
Yeah.
Even a breeding place for people who are cheating people out there.
Yes.
Yeah? Mm. Father, please tell us what is expected of us.
Okay.
From the church.
Yeah. First of all, church is the communion of the people.
Yes.
And we have the responsibility towards each other, towards the leaders of the church.
Correct.
These all things we have to understand properly.
Yeah.
What the law of the church, what you call the canon law, teaches us a few things that I am going to tell.
Correct.
Okay,
sure.
Yeah. First of all, to maintain a communion with every person and
right.
Be responsible for each and everyone.
Correct. Okay? Exactly.
Then to seek the truth about God and about the church and to live according to that truth.
Right.
For example, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father,
yeah.
The triune God. But how much we try to know about it. Suppose somebody asks us a question, we are not able to answer it. So we have to know the truth that we are professing. So it is our duty to know the truth about God. And about the church also.
Amen.
We just cannot take the church for granted. That I know the church. Church means sometimes the people take it as a building.
Yes.
There are different images of the church. The best image is the communion of the people.
People, yeah.
Okay? Yeah. That has to be known and you have to live.
Correct.
Another important duty is to obey the authority of the church.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Christ had given that authority to Peter.
Right.
Okay. Whatever you bind on earth shall be considered bound on earth in heaven, and whatever you lose on this earth shall be considered loosed in heaven.
Yeah.
So Christ has given that authority to the church, the leaders of the church, to preach the doctrines, the truths about the scriptures,
yes.
About the faith that you are professing.
Correct.
So what the church teaches, it is not simply from the dreams that the Holy Father and the church teaches.
Yeah.
It is well thought about, reflected upon, whether it is seen or right on the side of the scriptures and our faith,
right.
Reflected and meditated upon.
Right.
And then only that truth is propagated to the people to practice it.
Yes, yes.
So we have to accept it and respect the authorities.
Correct.
Today, the church authorities have become too cheap because there is so much of freedom that is given to the people, especially after the Vatican Second Council.
Right.
The
right.
Lay participation is so much in the church.
Right.
The church authorities are taken for granted and people are dominating over the priest now. Of course, we are the servants. We are there at the service of the people, yes, but we are not to be treated as slaves.
Correct.
The respect has to be given as the men of God, women of God,
yeah,
the priest
yeah.
And the religious. Okay?
Of course.
That is there.
Yes.
And all of us are called to lead a holy life. As Christians, we just cannot live a loose life. So
exactly.
We have to. Life of honor. that what we are professing the faith, the hands that are joined in prayer
yeah.
should reach out in the same way as God is reaching out, like just as Christ reached out to others. Not a place, because I'm praying
yeah.
and I'm doing good things, people are attracted, so I cannot take advantage of others.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
So I have the responsibility to lead a holy life.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Then, to receive communion,
yes.
participate in the Holy Eucharist and receive the communion.
Very important.
Go for confession, that is also our responsibility.
Yeah, yeah.
Then refrain from receiving the communion when you are in grave sin.
Yeah.
Okay, when you're living adultery, living relationship, when you committed murder, all these things you can just cannot come and you know receive the communion. You should realize that I'm a sinner. Okay. To fast on the days of fasting and abstain from meat during the Lenten
yes.
season on Ash Wednesday, Good Friday. These are the days of the fast. They are to be practiced. Yeah. Live the gospel values and proclaim them to others. It need not you take the Bible and go and preach to others.
No, no, no.
But at least, you know, by our way of life that we are Christians. We are
yes.
known as Christians by our way of life.
Correct.
That has to be practiced.
Correct.
And reject the doctrines that are contrary to our faith. There are so many false prophets, people are coming up, so many sects are coming up, so many denominations
yes.
that are coming
yes.
up.
Yes.
Okay, so reject them because they are evil. The false prophets that are coming up, antichrists are coming up in the world.
Yeah.
Avoid them, reject them.
Correct.
So, now the faith that has to be lived in the church, when you say, the basic church is our family. So live it in the family, the love. The relationship, the unity,
the prayer
read the gospel in the family, share the gospel values in the family, teach values to the children, pray together, eat together, live those values, then only we show our responsibility, our union with the church. First union in the family, then in the church.
Sure.
So there are so many responsibilities are there as taught by the
Correct.
Canon law. So we have to live them, then only we can be true Christians.
Right. Yeah. Very nice. Father, one thing, you know, people of late get tremendous pleasure of saying things against the priest.
Yeah.
You know, and getting into politics in the church. People were trying, this is such a sad thing, you know. We come there to pray.
Yes.
Yeah? And we don't come to play politics inside the church. But when I see such people, they remind me of the Pharisees in the past, no?
Yeah.
They were the same thing. Like they go around like big saints in the compound, but they are the biggest sinners around the place, you know. So I think, my dear brothers and sisters, we pray that we come for what Father has told us just now.
Yeah, God Almighty, Father, we thank and praise you for your Son who came into the world and established the church.
Yes.
The communion of the people
yes.
who believe in you, in your Son Jesus and the Holy Spirit. With the communion, with our communion with the Mother Mary and all the saints, and that communion is lived out on this earth. Give us the grace that we may realize our communion with you on this earth. And to know that church is a place, the physical building is a place to come and worship you
yes.
as a community of people and to find your presence there and to go out and live that graces and blessings that you obtain in the church and thus make us your true temples. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Yes, my brother.
Jesus loves you.
Hallelujah.
Yes.